Good morning, children. Let us study the first and the very important event in the process of sexual reproduction, that is gametogenesis. Genesis, formation, the process of formation of gametes. Sperm formation in male and ovum formation in female. Sperm formation is known as spermatogenesis and ovum formation is known as oogenesis. Whether it is in male or female, the process of gametogenesis, this include three stages: multiplication, growth, and the maturation. The process of spermatogenesis, this we have already done, that it occurs in seminiferous tubules of testes. And this occurs in two steps. The first step, spermatids are formed. And the second step, these spermatids, they are converted into sperms. So now let us study the first phase, multiplication phase. As the name indicates, multiply. The germinal epithelium of testes, and one thing, students, this germinal epithelium is cuboidal epithelium. This germinal epithelium, it will keeps on dividing, and this form the cells which are called spermatogonia. And one thing more, this division is mitosis division. It means spermatogonia, they are also diploid. The spermatogonia so formed here, they are of two types, spermatogonia A and spermatogonia B. Now, what is the difference between this A and B? Spermatogonia A, they will keep on dividing by mitosis division. It means they remains in multiplication phase. But type B spermatogonia, they leave the multiplication phase and they enter into the next phase, that is growth phase. In this growth phase, there is protein formation and other synthesis. So simply it grows in size. And now this is known as primary spermatocyte. And still it is diploid. It is having 46 chromosome. After growth phase, now it enters into maturation phase. In maturation phase, meiotic division will occur. And students, we know that meiotic division, it occurs in two stages. So primary spermatocyte first divide by first meiotic division, and when it divide by the first meiotic division, the number of chromosomes get reduced to half. Now instead of 46 chromosome, it has 23 chromosome, or we can say this is haploid condition. Now these are known as secondary spermatocytes. These secondary spermatocytes now will divide by the second meiotic division. And this second meiotic division is just like the mitotic division. So simply they each spermatocyte divides into two. So at the end of second meiotic division, four spermatids are formed. I am saying spermatids. These are not spermatozoa, these are not sperms, these are spermatids. These are haploid. Now these spermatids, they undergo a process by which they are converted into spermatozoa. And this process of conversion of spermatid into spermatozoa is known as spermiogenesis. Now these sperms, they embed their head into Sertoli cells. We have already done, students, that Sertoli cells, these are there in the seminiferous tubule in between the germ cells. Now, after some time, these sperms will be released from the Sertoli cells. This process of release of sperms from the Sertoli cell is known as spermiation. In this slide, I have shown you how this process of spermatogenesis is hormone regulated. The process of spermatogenesis, as we know, it starts only at puberty. So at puberty, hypothalamus starts secreting a hormone known as GnRH, gonadotropin releasing hormone. This hormone is a sort of message for the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland. GnRH is giving message to anterior pituitary to secrete two hormones, FSH and LH. FSH is follicle stimulating hormone and LH is luteinizing hormone. FSH act on the Sertoli cell and LH it acts on the Leydig cells. Students, we know Leydig cells are also known as interstitial cells. These are present in between the seminiferous tubule, Sertoli cells in the seminiferous tubule. When LH act on Leydig cells, it stimulate Leydig cells to secrete androgen. And one of the androgen we know is testosterone. FSH, it act on the Sertoli cells. And because of this, Sertoli cells, they secrete androgen binding protein. ABP. Now these androgen binding protein, they bind with the androgen, they increase the concentration of androgen in seminiferous tubule. So these increase the or stimulate the process of spermatogenesis. Sertoli cells, these are also secreting another hormone that is called inhibin. Inhibin is responsible for the negative feedback. Negative feedback means inhibin will go and act on the anterior pituitary gland. As a result, now anterior pituitary gland will not secrete FSH. Similarly, when there is excess of testosterone, again this is giving a message to anterior pituitary that it is enough. Don't secrete any LH now. So when no LH is secreted or less LH is secreted, then less stimulation of Leydig cells, less secretion of testosterone. So in this way, testosterone, it balances its secretion by itself. This is a way to maintain homeostasis. In this slide, again, I have explained you the hormonal regulation of spermatogenesis that I have already explained you in the previous slide. As this slide is showing us the structure of the male gamete. This is the male gamete and this is known as spermatozoa or simply sperm. This is a single cell structure. You can see this part. This is called head. There is a small neck part here. This is a middle piece and a long flagellar tail. In front of the head, you can see acrosome. These acrosomes, they are nothing but condensed Golgi bodies. acrosome, they play very important role at the time of fertilization. When sperm has to enter into ovum, it has to pass through the corona radiata and the zona pellucida layer. So the secretion of this acrosome, they help sperm to dissolve these layer and to penetrate into the ovum. Now this head part is having the nucleus, and nucleus is having all the DNA content, the chromosomal material that it is going to carry from the father to the growing embryo, zygote. The neck is having two centriole. One is proximal centriole and one is the distal centriole. So one centriole is playing an important role in the formation of this flagella, and the other proximal centriole is giving stimulus to the secondary oocyte so that it can complete its second meiotic division. That I am going to explain you when we are going to do the oogenesis process. Now middle piece is having mitochondria. Now why so many mitochondria are required here? See, sperm has to move. Sperm has to move throughout the female genital tract, throughout the uterus, then it has to reach to the fallopian tube. For that, it needs energy. And energy is provided from ATP, and ATPs, they are stored in mitochondria. This flagellar tail, I think by now it should be very clear to you ki what is the role of this tail. This tail is helping the sperm in movement.